door, and they came in, they busted open the sacristy door, 100-year-old door that they broke into like criminals, and came in, talked to us, asked us if we would go peacefully. We all said no, we weren't.
Police go into a church and arrest three people after they defy Archdiocese orders. Church leaders say the move was necessary to end two illegal vigils.
But parishioners at both churches say they're ready to continue fighting. WDSU anchor Toslyn Alfonso is live right now from one of the closed churches with tonight's big local story. Toslyn.
Well, the arrest took place today between 11:45 and 1 o'clock this afternoon. Parishioners were inside holding a 24-hour vigil, which they've been doing since October. But today, the Archdiocese of New Orleans went in and forced them to leave.
Patrolman, butler, please allow us to enter.
Sir,
please let us in.
A handful of parishioners from Our Lady of Good Counsel defied police orders and tried to enter the church. They wanted to meet up with Dorothy Payton and three other people inside participating in the 24-hour vigil.
This is awful. Like I said, I'm 72 years old. I never thought in this day and age that I or any people would be put out of a church.
This is a very poor example of religion. Not only is it not Catholic, it's not even Christian.
Watch your head, Hunter. Climb in there, man.
Hunter Harris and Poppy Bright were taken away in handcuffs, charged with criminal trespassing and resisting arrest.
Hunter and I were kneeling in the pews, saying the rosary. They dragged us both out and arrested us.
Wallens police treated us very nice, and we was treated well at lockup.
This is the 10th week that parishioners had occupied the church, refusing to accept the Archbishop's decision to close its doors for good. The Archdiocese of New Orleans says the closure is part of a restructuring plan meant to address Katrina damage, a decrease in parishioners, and a nationwide priest shortage. After parishioners barred the door and refused to let the Archdiocese inspect the building, a spokesperson for the Archdiocese says it was their legal right to secure the building, and they did so with police force.
And I think it's ridiculous that they would arrest us for being in our church and praying there, but if that's what they want to do, then I'm ready to go again.
Now, over at St. Henry's, another church forced to close. It was a similar story. There were three parishioners inside the church holding a vigil. Police were on hand along with the Archdiocese asking parishioners to leave. One parishioner, Cynthia Rabideau, made a deal with police to go inside the church and finish the vigil.
They agreed that if I would, I could trade places with the three people in the church as long as I would not make them arrest me physically and make a scene and make them take me to jail. If I would accept a summons instead, then they would allow those parishioners to leave.
Now, Rabideau must appear in court, but no other St. Henry's parishioners were physically arrested. Rabideau also told us that the Archdiocese went inside the church, they took inventory, and then they locked the doors. On your side, live from Uptown, Toslyn Alfonso, WDSU, News Channel 6.
Quite a day. Thank you, Toslyn. Meantime, members of St. Henry's plan to hold a news conference tomorrow night on the steps of the church and invite all former and current parishioners to attend. Archbishop Hughes is out of town right now, but he did release a statement that reads in part, quote, "It has always been the intention of the Archdiocese to bring these vigils to a peaceful conclusion. This forced closure involving the NOPD is the result of actions of protesters at former parishes. This decision was made reluctantly after exploring every possible alternative, including multiple attempts to persuade the people to leave the building on their own."